This guy put a skateboard under his turtle. To experience. Look how the turtle gets up to speed and then coasts. It's like it understands and desires to move fast, but is unable to do so because of limitations of its body.
Why did you poke the frog? But it's just a frog! Make it get off!
Yo, TikTok, you want to see a plant that'll make you sleep, calm your mind, and is really good for ADHD? And this one's also for the 420 crew, because it's a cousin of what it looks like. Well, it won't put you in the sky, but it does all the rest. Well, if you do, then welcome back to the UK's medicinal plants. This plant is so good at doing what it looks like it does, Henry VIII once banned it in the UK. This plant is a cousin of the one that shall not be named on TikTok. This plant has been used traditionally in herbal medicine, taken orally in teas or the other way, for tension, anxiety or induced sleeping. In fact, this plant is so powerful at inducing sleeping, it was once considered a cure for insomnia, and you're not allowed this plant in your system when you're going in for surgery, because combined with anesthesia, there is fears it will cause too. Yo, TikTok, you want to see a plant that'll make you sleep, calm your mind, and is really good for ADHD? And this one's also for the...
Today I learned that over 50% of the population doesn't have an inner monologue.
I'm actually one of those individuals that never had an inner monologue, and I didn't quite get it until I hit the point of, we'll call it sympathetic overdrive or burnout. When I was learning about meditation and individuals would say, just watch the thoughts come and go, I'm like, what? It's just quiet, it's silence. I don't really get that. Or I would have individuals describe to me, I'm thinking before bed, you know, I can't fall asleep because of all these thoughts. And I didn't get it. I was like, just go to sleep. I had no idea what individuals were talking about when they were describing this concept of inner monologue because I had never experienced it. And then I remember, I actually called my colleague who is a psychologist and started working with her because I was having a massage, and all of a sudden, in the massage, I was like, I'm talking to myself about remembering to book a chiropractor appointment. I'm in a massage. I thought I was losing my mind. And then I come to find out that individuals have this inner monologue that I had never experienced, where they are essentially replaying their day or talking to themselves. And this is what I've learned. I think that I was so good at living in the present moment that I would do what I was doing when I was doing it, and there was no other thoughts after that. When I was sleeping, I was going to sleep. When I was working, I was concentrating on working. When I'm with my kids, I'm with my kids. There was no inner monologue. And this is just my experience. But when I went through a significant amount of stress that became chronic day in and day out, that's when I started to realize that there was this monologue. And I think what it's actually coming from in my case is the anxiety of future events. And the more that you can pull yourself back into the present day, back into your body, what you are doing, I'm finding personally, through working with my psychologist, that this inner monologue is getting quieter and quieter. But I seriously thought I was going crazy.